Take one, go. Well, hello there, Java Minecraft players that like to play Java Minecraft on their Android device. Today, we're gonna have a war. We're gonna have a war between Xaleth Launcher and Pojav Launcher. Well, it's actually called Amethyst Launcher now, and we're gonna basically just listen to why I think neither one of them is better than the other. Yeah, none of them. There's not one launcher on Android right now that I would say is better than the other because, well, watch this video and I'm gonna share everything I know about these two launchers that basically proves my point. So, to get the introduction out of the way, the one that I'm using right now is just the Xaleth Launcher. Now, the reason why is just because I like Xaleth Launcher. I like the way that it's loaded. I like the way that it's set up. I like how it just seems to work for most game modes. What I mean by that is basically when I go in here and I download a mod pack, most mod packs usually run that are compatible at least. Now there are a lot of mod packs that aren't compatible, but that's just basically knowing how to configure certain things. Now today isn't really about a mod pack, but this is why I'm in here. This menu right here allows you to download mods, mod packs, resource packs, worlds, and shader packs very easily. Why is that good? That makes it so that you don't have to leave the application, go to Google Chrome, where is it right there, and then start downloading everything one by one. So if I have to go to Modrinth and then I have to search for these mods and then download them one by one and then go into my file manager and copy all of those files by going into Amethyst, open game directory, get all these mods, it's just a big convoluted annoying mess. Whereas Xaleth Launcher, this is how easy it is. Grab a launcher or a loader, install it. I'm gonna go with Forge, maybe not Forge with that version. Let's go with a different version. And there's another version right there. Forge, this one, Optifine. Oh yeah, and you can download Optifine right directly through the mod or the loader as well, or the launcher. I know I get my words mixed up. That's just because I'm just so excited to share with you why not even Mojo Launcher on the Google Play Store is better than any of these launchers. People always are like, oh, Mojo Launcher is better than this one, and Pojav Launcher is better, and Amethyst is better. You're just starting a war for no reason, and that's why I'm here to kind of defer you from doing that, because our government is so corrupt that they start wars for stupid things that we don't even know as citizens as to why they start wars. So why would you start a war between two launchers that are trying to just help you play Java Minecraft? Let's just wait for Forge to finish downloading now. So now I can go into Forge, go to download mod, or I can download it from CurseForge or Modrinth, and basically I can grab what loader I want, search, and then I can download all the mods that are compatible. And even this mod loader actually tells you certain things, like for certain mods, just like Modrinth does. So if you've ever used Modrinth, so if you go here, tree harvester mod, for example, you go down to, it usually scrolls to it. I think it's because I clicked the screen too fast. There we go. It'll tell you, hey, you need Collective. Instead of downloading Collective though, like that part's kind of annoying, but it just tells you that you need it. So it would be cool if they had that feature just like Modrinth does. And CurseForge, really. But honestly, that's just so fast. Now I can just go play the game. Whereas, again, Amethyst does not have that. They don't have this awesome feature where you can just go download mods. Now you can download mod packs, which is right here, and there they are. But also when you go into mod packs, you can only select a version. So there's only like a way to just select which version you want it for. So now you have fabulously optimized both on CurseForge and Forge. You don't have a way to cycle through this for just Modrinth or Forge or CurseForge. As you can see here, there's all the mod packs and everything. But again, the UI is one of the biggest features of launchers, in my opinion, that really makes a launcher a launcher. Now, one big thing that Amethyst differs is a little bit more of a simplistic setup, but everything is a learning curve, no matter what. So I didn't know how to use Modrinth back in the day when I first started using it. Even this, Pojav Launcher, might be confusing to anybody. People say, oh, it's easy, but yeah, it's people that have been using it for a while. Settings icon, render, like, well, where do you go in here? What are you doing here if you don't know what you're doing? Extra render settings, what does this mean? Like, some people don't even know that, and that's where YouTube videos come in handy, because, like, guides like mine show you what to do in here. Now, again, this is just me just sharing, hey, this is my thoughts. Now, renderers, so a lot of renderers have updates. So the Mobile Glues render is still outdated on Amethyst, and hopefully they catch up and add the latest update. But Xaleth Launcher, we don't have to worry about that. Now, if we get out of this game in a second, I'm just going to wait for this to load. There we go. Now, I'm going to quit the game. I'm not going to play the game. I'm just showing you how fast that was. I can go into settings, and I can install what are called renderer plugins. Okay, so as you can see here, I have multiple different plugins. Now, some devices like Adreno GPUs, sometimes they benefit from using the Vulkan Zinc renderer, which allows you to use like a turnip driver, basically, sort of thing, if you know what I'm talking about. We have the Mesa driver plugin right here for Mesa 25, and that helps with rendering some versions of the game and also with some versions that require you to use like shaders. And this is the Agen 2 processor that's in this device. I'm using what is called the AYN Odin 2. And what this does is just gives you another option for a renderer if one of these other renderers isn't working for you. And the thing about this is that, like emulation, so I do a lot of emulation stuff, this will give you that turnip driver that gives you better graphic support and better rendering. So turnip driver right here, turnip 25.1, SDK 29. And basically this just helps with rendering the graphics, because Java Minecraft is not natively able to be played on our devices, our phones, our tablets, whatever the case may be. There's so many other features in here too, like game settings. So you can go into your game settings and you can actually see how much RAM you could allocate, which is very important for a lot of mod packs. So like this device has 12 gigs of RAM, or 11.01 after Android takes some of it. And it tells me that I have 7 gigs free. Now, would I suggest allocating that much? Not really, maybe like 5 to 6, but honestly 4 to 5 is pretty good for 12 gigs of RAM, honestly. And then it depends on the mod pack. So if you have big mod packs that say, hey, you need to allocate at least 6 gigs of RAM, and you don't have that much, then you're technically not going to be able to play it. Control settings, I like how the control settings are laid out too. Remap controller, so like if I wanted to change the left mouse to be some other button, it actually shows a keyboard on screen instead of you have to scroll through a list. It actually has a keyboard to tell you, you know, what button is what. So like I have this set up for my left joystick as the left shift, so I can click on left shift on the keyboard and it just basically sets that. That's a cool feature as well. Launcher settings, you don't really need to mess around with anything like that in here, but like that's something that's also on Amethyst. Experimental settings, you don't need to touch anything in here, never really need to touch anything in here. I'm just going to tell you that right now. And the main thing is just basically your video settings, control settings, and all of the other features like downloading mods easily. The last feature that I really, really like and is very, very important to me, because A, scope storage gives you access to store files on a location of your device that you choose. So what I mean by that, as you can see right here, I have two different locations on the right hand side. So I have a folder in my actual device right now that's called Xalethcraft. Okay, so if I go to my file manager, which I'm going to show you that in a second here, I have a folder on my root directory of my actual device called Xalethcraft, and all of my files are stored in here. So anything that when I'm logged into my Microsoft account and I install the game, anything goes into there. What does that mean? Well, if I uninstall Xaleth Launcher and I wanted to reinstall it again, or maybe I delete this path. Okay, let's do that. Let's pretend that this is brand new Xaleth Launcher. I want to add new path. I can go to that folder again. I can press check mark. I can name this whatever I want, main folder, whatever the case may be, it doesn't matter. And I can click on that and I have everything still there, like including my saves, my mods and everything. Whereas the default path on Xaleth Launcher is in the data directory, and also the default path in Amethyst is also in the data directory. So why is that very important? Well, because maybe you get a new phone, you want to transfer your game saves, or maybe you accidentally uninstalled Amethyst, deleted all the data. There's so many different cases why that's good. Have scope storage directory, which is just another feature as well. And I like that. I like that because even on the PC, you can actually tell CurseForge and Modern where you want to store your game files, and that lets you basically keep them stored somewhere safer. I'm not going to say safe, but safer, because at least you know that all the files are in there. Also, you could have like categories. So maybe you want this to just be your vanilla Minecraft with some mods, and you can make another one for like horror mods or something, you know what I mean? So like this is a folder for horror mods, and then you can check mark and name this horror. So maybe you want to have a whole bunch of different horror mods inside a folder, which is always great, right? Like that's awesome. The other features that this has is like open main directory allows you to go right into your actual folders of your device. You can like copy files from your Android data. Well, when you're actually in the main head of the folder, you can do that, but you can't do it when you're out of the folder. So like let's say you created a folder after the fact, you can grab all these file folders and everything and basically paste them on the root directory of your device. And it allows you to do that. So like if I wanted to paste everything in here, I could. So that's why I like that as well. So now if I select this, I can go back and there's my Forge profile, right? So another thing is we have the share logs. That's pretty self-explanatory, but now we have also, you can go into this folder right here and go share logs and share it to Discord if you need to very easily, rather than having to like go into Amethyst, go to open game directory, find Amethyst, scroll down to latest logs, click on it by mistake or long press on it, then share, and now it'll let you go to Discord. So like there's just so many features that Xaelith Launcher has over Amethyst, but Amethyst has support for mods like Controllable and Controlify. Xaelith Launcher does not have support for this right now. So like this enable SDL backend right here, this allows you to play with Controlify and Controllable for like mods like Legacy 4J, which has Controlify built into it, or Controllable. Controllable is a big mod that allows you to use a controller, and I think it's better than the default controllers that we have, because you can change things like how fast your mouse goes on the screen. You can change things how fast your character turns and everything. I know that's the mouse speed as well, but the Controllable and Controlify are a lot better at doing that than just changing your mouse speed. So like there's a whole bunch of different things where it's like, hey, I can make a mod pack in Xaelith Launcher, for example, and then I could copy that mod pack over to Amethyst, which is definitely an option. So like maybe I make all my mod packs in Xaelith Launcher, and then I basically copy my mod pack, which is this Forge one right here. I can take this, go to copy to, and paste it into Amethyst. I can put it anywhere in here, by the way. And then I go to Amethyst, and then I install Forge, which is for that one version that we just selected. So I'll install that Forge profile, let it install. And like these are just tips and stuff about things that you can think about when you're using both of these launchers. You could have both launchers installed. Just make sure that both aren't running at the same time, because obviously that's going to consume your actual RAM and everything and your performance. But I go here, I go to basically custom path, Forge, select this folder, and make sure that I select mobile glues and internal 21 and play. We should be able to get all those mods inside of Amethyst as well without any issues. Like all those mods are just going to load because we made that mod pack in Xaelith Launcher, which you could just basically use Xaelith Launcher as a mod pack maker if you want to, and then play it on Amethyst, especially if you want to use things like Controllable or Legacy 4J or whatever. See, as you can see here, mods, remember we downloaded Entity Calling, Cloth Config, Tree Harvester, there it is right there. And if you don't believe me, I'm going to jump right into it right now and show you that everything just works and that you could just do what I just did. What do you guys think? Is Xaelith Launcher the best? Pojav Launcher the best? Even though Pojav Launcher development is dead? Amethyst? Mojo Launcher? Or are you not one-sided and you just think that they're all great because they let you play Java Minecraft on your Android device, and there's been a team of people that have helped with letting us do so? Not sure why the controller's not working. Maybe it's because I messed around with some settings. Who knows? Have a nice day, guys. Hope you enjoy that. Take care. See you next time. And as always,